my very privilege to share my knowledge with you all. So first of all, I am just sharing the screen with you. This is visible to you?
Yes, sir, we can see it.
Okay. Okay, so today's topic is on introduction to the SWOT model and its geospatial applications. There are various applications of soil and water assessment tool in not only in our agricultural field. There are so many applications. So I am going to interact, not just give to demonstration. So in my lecture, I will be covering the topic on a brief introduction about the soil and water assessment tool. Then basically, as Dr. Vikramji told me that the participants are from the, basically they are new to the course. So just it is very important to deal with or start with the basics of the SWOT. Otherwise, model running, it is very simple and easy. So I will be covering the basics of the soil and water assessment tool, its concepts, components, and its application, where we can apply the soil and water assessment tool. Once we have a basic idea about the SWOT, its components, then the next important thing is the creation of the SWOT database. Because SWOT is a data intensive tool, it needs a different kinds of inputs to get the required output. So we will see basically the creation of database and then SWOT model setup, as there are two options are there with us. That is, one is by using the open source QGIS software, we can use the QSWAT, and another one is the ArcGIS software, we can use the ArcSWAT. So in this case, I will be going to demonstrate you a QGIS, because that is open source and everybody can afford. Before demonstration, I will be I'm just showing you one of the case study on the SWAT, so that you will get familiar with the SWAT and how we can apply it in different fields. And then we'll have the concluding remark. So basically, SWAT is an developed by the United States Department of USDA, that is United States Department of America, Agricultural Research Services, which the SWAT can be applicable in case of the river basin scale, watershed scale, micro watershed, sub watershed scale, we can apply. So it is basically a long-term, physically based, spatially distributed, and continuous time step model, which generally uses the daily time step. It incorporates the effects of tanks and the reservoirs, check dams, upstream as well as onstream. So basically, this SWAT model is very useful, but which requires a different input parameters, like weather parameters, soil parameters, topographical parameters, vegetation, land and management practices. The very basic feature, or you can say specialty of the SWAT, is SWAT allows us to subdivide the watersheds, or you can say the basin into the sub-basins or the watershed levels. So basically, it is allows us a like say this subdivision is beneficial when different areas of the basin are dominated by different land use and land cover and the soil types. So this is basically very important. And SWAT, basically what SWAT does, SWAT model groups the input information for each watershed. So in a river basin, if we have a multiple watersheds or the sub watersheds, the SWAT groups a similar information, which are called as the hydrologic response units. We will see these hydrological response units in detail while giving the demonstration. So the major advantage of the SWAT is SWAT requires a minimum, you can say, does not require a calibration. When, like say, with a minimum, like the major advantage of the SWAT is, which does not require a much calibration. That's why we can use this model for the ungauged watersheds. So here, the SWAT basically, it is basically gives us a output, all water balance components like the surface runoff, evaporation, lateral flow, groundwater recharge, percolation, sediment yield at daily, monthly, or annual time steps. So this is just an interface of the SWAT, how different components are involved in the SWAT model. So these are the weather parameters, and we can we can run the SWAT for getting the output of it is related with the point source as well as the non-point source. And these are the land use management practices, then soils, topography. These are some of the inputs we required for running the model. So as we all know that running on SWAT, 1 hour or 1.5 hour lecture is very small. It is not useful, or you can say it is very difficult to cover the complete SWAT in a very short period of time. But even though, I will try to cover briefly, so that in detail we can learn in the next coming courses. So SWAT basically, there are two options in the SWAT for the calibration. So as you all know, for any model, calibration and validation is very important. If your calibration and validation is correct, then only you will get the required output what you expect. So there are different ways. One is the automatic calibration by using the SWAT cup model, and another is the manual calibration. So manual calibration is tiresome, but you can also use the SWAT cup. So in this webinar, it is very difficult to cover the SWAT cup. So we'll skip that one, but I will show you how to do the manual calibration. SWAT has many wide application, diversified applications in interdisciplinary level at national and international levels. SWAT can be used extensively to predict the effect of agricultural management decisions and assessing the impacts of land use and climate change on the water resources and non-point source pollution problems across the globe. So as I told you, modeling of ungauged catchments, it is very, very useful. The SWAT model, we can use it, and as well as we can also predict the relative impacts of alternative scenarios. Like suppose if there is any change in the management practices or climate or land use land cover change, so what will be the impact on water quality and quantity? So in addition with these applications, we can also use the SWAT for tracking the environmental problems like the water quantity and quality, nutrient cycling, and in-stream processes. What are the processes occurring? So now briefly, I'm going to just cover what are the different components of the SWAT. So SWAT basically involves the two basic components. One is the land phase of the hydrologic cycle, which includes the amount of water, sediment, nutrient, and pesticide loadings to the main channel in each sub-basin. Okay. And the next one is the routing phase of the hydrologic cycle. So which defines the movement of these, like water, sediments, nutrients through the channel network of the watershed to the outlet. So land phase and routing phase, these are the two important components of the SWAT model. So we will just briefly see what are the land components and what are the routing components. So in case of land phase of the hydrologic cycle, which involves the weather parameters like precipitation, temperature, then solar radiation, relative humidity, wind speed. These are the important weather parameters which we need to provide for the SWAT model. Then the hydrologic components. Hydrologic components means like say stream flow or stream discharge, then sediment, then evapotranspiration, groundwater recharge, return flow, then percolation, infiltration. These are the some of the hydrological components. Then sediment, then crop growth, nutrient cycling, pesticides, and management practices. Like if there is any management practices available in the watersheds. So these are covered under the land phase. So now I'm just very briefly, I'm just going to show you each of these components. So I mentioned you the SWAT weather parameters. Okay, so SWAT requires a daily input data. This is we have to remember. So whatever the parameters, input parameters, climate, weather variables, you have to provide on a daily basis. So if you don't have the some of these parameters like the temperature or the precipitation, there is an inbuilt weather generator is there. So it will generate the weather parameters for you. So for better accuracy, measured, but as you remember, if you want a good accuracy, it is always better to provide the observed data. So here, SWAT generates the precipitation, as I already told you, by using the weather generator. So it generates basically based on the dry day and wet day approach. So here, as I told you, after the precipitation, the temperature is the one of the important input for the SWAT model. So temperature, it considers also if there is any snow cover or snow packs are available in the watershed, it will automatically consider and it will generate the required output for the model. So in case of this snow is melted on days, okay, when the maximum temperature exceeds. So SWAT considers using this, there is a lapse rate and those details are there, it will consider and it will be accounted in the final output. So SWAT basically simulates the hydrological cycle based on the water balance equation. I think the most of the participants knows the water balance equation. Okay, so this is a simple water balance equation, which is useful, which can be used in the SWAT model. So that is basically the rainfall or a precipitation occurring on the land surface minus the losses in terms of the surface runoff, in terms of the seepage flow, in terms of the groundwater, or in terms of the evapotranspirations on a daily basis. Okay, and this is the initial and final SWT is the final soil water content, and SW naught is the initial soil water content. So as in the SWAT is basically a continuous water follows the continuous water balance approach. Okay, and it also enables to reflect the differences in the evapotranspiration for the various crops and soils. So there is a intensive database is available in the SWAT database file. I will show you during the demonstration. So, and then it runoff is predicted separately for each sub basin area and routed to obtain the total runoff for the basin. That means SWAT will simulate the runoff for each of the sub basin, and finally it will give a total runoff at the outlet of the watershed. So this is a brief, you can say the flow chart in the SWAT model. So here you see the precipitation, it will be considered a rain or the snow. Then it will be like the infiltration, then the different, like if there is any irrigation in the given to the in the for the crops, and then it will consider the surface runoff, then stream flow, irrigation divergence, transmission losses, and then finally so these are the different components which will be considered in the SWAT model. I'm not going in detail. So in the SWAT model, for estimating the surface runoff, the curve number method is applied. Basically there are two approaches are applied. One is the Green and Arm method for estimating the surface runoff, okay, it is applied in the in the SWOT model. So this is basically or the second one is the modified soil conservation service curve number method. So here this is like curve number operates on a daily time step. So curve number basically decreases as the soil moisture approaches the wilting point and increases to the near to the 100 as the soil approaches the saturation. So this is in detail you can see in the soil SWAT user manual also. Then how the SWAT estimates the surface runoff. So for estimating the surface runoff, this is the standard well-known equation SWAT uses in the estimation of the surface runoff. Okay, so this is the like first is the Q surface, then this equation that is R day minus 0.2S bracket square divided by R day plus 0.8S, where S is the surface retention capacity of the soil and which is related with the curve number. So this is the empirical equation which the SWAT uses. Then the SWAT also, so there are two things, like it's a total volume of runoff and another is the peak rate of runoff. So peak rate of runoff, which is estimated by using the modified rational formula. This is the Q peak is equal to alpha Tc into Q surface into area divided by 3.6 into Tc, that is time of concentration. So these are basically, again, the time of concentration is basically the summation of the overland flow and the channel flow. So which can be estimated by using these two equations. So here, for estimation of the soil conservation service curve number method, we need the daily precipitation and the curve number will be estimated for the AMC second conditions. So I think basically this will be clear for all the participants. If you have some background related with the hydrology, then green and amped equation, this is basically we need the sub-daily scale rainfall data, but for Indian condition it is very difficult to get the sub-daily scale rainfall data. If you are, then you can use it in it for the particular watershed. Then saturated hydraulic conductivity, bulk density of the soil, clay content and the sand content we need. So for computation of the peak rate of runoff, we need the average slope of the watershed and the slope stiffness factor, that is Manning's slope stiffness factor, as well as the Manning's coefficient for the overland flow and tributary channel flow, longest tributary channel length and average slope of the tributary channel. So this all we can get it from the slope map. So here particularly the lateral subsurface flow, we can estimate the input data for required. So each of these, there is a parameter and there is a what are the data we required that is given. Like for estimating the lateral subsurface flow, we need the hill slope length, saturated hydraulic conductivity and average slope of the basin. So SWAT also, there is an important component, evapotranspiration in the SWAT. Okay, so ET is basically estimated by using the Penman-Martin method, Priestley-Taylor method and Hargreaves method. Okay, so these are the three methods. But in general, there are so many methods are there which we can use for estimating the PET. But in SWAT, these three methods are available. For estimating the ET, that is the potential evapotranspiration, which required the daily wind speed, carbon dioxide concentration, daily maximum and minimum temperature, and maximum leaf conductance. So basically, it depends on now what input you are providing. So accordingly, you can select the model. Then in case of the groundwater can be, so basically SWAT is not basically designed for the groundwater modeling. Basically SWAT consider the shallow aquifer groundwater recharge. Okay, so just keep in mind when you apply the SWAT model, okay, for studying the groundwater related component. So SWAT can simulate the water storage structures. Like suppose in your watersheds, if you have some ponds or reservoirs available in the watersheds. So if you have the data regarding with the particular capacity of each of the structure, like the pond water storage, which is basically, it is a function of the pond capacity, how much is the inflow and outflow and seepage and evaporation. If you have this data, you can provide to the model. Model will simulate further for taking any actions or any water management strategy in the watersheds. Okay. So regarding the sediment or the SWAT, computes the erosion or the sediment yield for each HRE using the modified universal soil loss equation. I think most of the participants, they know how we can estimate the soil erosion. So basic equation is universal soil loss equation, and then there are many revisions are coming up in this equation for estimating the sediment yield. So in SWAT, modified universal soil loss equation is used. So I'm not going in detail here. So SWAT also can be applicable in the nitrogen and pesticides studies. Okay, so like in agriculture, so SWAT is basically useful, very useful for the agricultural watersheds. Okay, where we can study the how much is the fertilizers can be applied for any specific crops, and some management strategies, okay, regarding the nitrogen and the pesticides. Okay, so these are the basics of this one. And for this, the input data required is related with the potential heat units for the plant growing in each of the HRUs, then minimum temperature for the plant growth, and so on. So there are so many other data also required, okay, like timing of the planting, tillage, fertilizer, irrigation operation, quantity of fertilizer, manure, depth of irrigations. These are so many data which required for studying the these pesticides and the nitrogen's recycling in the watersheds. So then there is a next component of the other than the land phase, that is the routing phase. So in case of the routing, there are two basic things, like main channel routing and the next one is the reservoir routing. Okay, so in again there are further, it is subdivided: channel flow routing, channel sediment routing, and channel nutrient routing, and channel pesticide routing. Okay, in case of reservoir, if there is a reservoir water balance, reservoir sediment routing, and reservoir nutrients and the pesticides routing. So basically, these are the important components. Again, this in detail for this routing, what are the what is the basics applied and what are the inputs required that is given. So I'm not going in detail all this, because we also have to see the demonstration of the SWAT. Okay, so it will take much time in the demonstration. So with this is the basics of the SWAT model. Okay, what are the components of the SWAT models we have seen. Now, very important is creation of the SWAT database and model setup. So I'm just going to show you now what are the softwares, different softwares required for creating the SWAT database. Like, we need a ERDAS software for ERDAS or NV or ER mapper software for creating and land use land cover map. You can say land use land cover maps. Okay, so this is the one of the basic input we required for the SWAT. Then we need the RGIS or the QGIS software. QGIS is is a open source software which is easily and freely available in the public domain, which the participants can use. And another is the RGIS. This is the protected software which requires the license. Okay, so both these softwares are very useful and interactive and user friendly, which we can use for the database creation and the spatial analysis. And hydrological modeling in detail by using the SWAT, we can use the QSWAT on the QGIS platform and ArcSWAT on a ArcGIS platform. Okay, so I will show you during the demonstration, first of all, how to download the software, then how to install the software, okay, and how to prepare the database briefly. So it is, as I told you, there is a very short time, so we cannot each and every database we can prepare here, but at least I can show you what are the database we need to prepare. So here, now As I initially told that I'm not going to take ArcGIS software or ArcSwag because it is the protected versions, okay? And most of the participants, they cannot afford the protected software or licensed software. But we have the QGIS, which is a freely available open source software. So SWAT is embedded in the QGIS, okay? That is we called as the QSWAT. So there are many versions of QSWAT are available. So you can download any latest version of the SWAT, QSWAT and install, okay? And then you can work. So SWAT is, so before going QSWAT, the participants should know basics or little things about the QGIS, okay? So the QGIS has, you can say, the capability which can be embedded in the SWAT model and which is very user friendly. We can easily work with the SWAT, okay? So this is the QSWAT software, QGIS interface. And this is the QSWAT installed. So I will show you in detail, not necessary to go here. So what are the input data requirement for the SWAT model? Okay. So I already told you SWAT is a data comprehensive model, okay, which requires a number of data. Okay. So those data can be classified into the two types, like one is the special data sets and another is the you can say the text data files. Okay. So special data sets, what are the special data sets we require? We require the QGIS compatible raster data sets as well as the vector data sets. Like we need the land use land cover, we need the soil information. Okay. So these are the special data sets which we need in terms of the grid and the shapefile format. Okay. As well as the digital elevation models. Then the text file is, we require the weather parameters, so that will be provided in terms of the text files, as well as the some of the basic characteristics of the watersheds. Okay, so this prior to the setup of the this QSWAT, which we need to prepare the basic data sets. So here, this is just the highlight, okay, that what are the data we require and from where we can get this data. Okay, so very first we need the digital elevation model in the SWAT, okay, so which we can be we can get the SWAT we can get the digital elevation model from different sources. Okay, so one is the SRTM 30 meter or SRTM Aster DM 90 meter, you can download from the these websites. Okay, as well as you can also download or you can create your own digital elevation model by using the two approaches. One is from the topo sheets, you can digitize the contours and then you can create, or another is you can do the GPS survey. Then land use land cover map, second, this is also very important. You can get the land use land cover map either from the National Remote Sensing Center, from the government of India, or the Global Land Use Land Cover Facility, okay, GLCF. I will show you this website. Then the next one is the soil map. Soil map, which you can get from the two sources, either from Food and Agricultural Classified Soil Map, or the, in case of Indian conditions, we can get it from the NBSS, National Bureau of Soil Science, Soil Survey, Nagpur, okay. So, and the climatic data like precipitation, temperature, wind speed, relative humidity, or solar radiation, in case of Indians, we can get this data from the Indian Meteorological Department, or there is also database which are created by the SWAT users, SWAT developers, and then it will be available in the SWAT website. Then next one is the hydrological data. This is also very important data sets which we required for the model calibration and validation. Okay, so observed stream flow, then observed river flow, or if we have the runoff data from the watershed, as well as the sediment data, okay, which we can get it from the concerned state government or central government water resources department, or some of the data can be collected through the field experiment. So in special data, we require there are like optional data sets and some of the mandatory data sets like digital elevation model, land use land cover maps, and soil maps. These are the mandatory which we require for the SWAT some model setup. Okay, so optional data sets are like streams or user defined watersheds or outlets. Like sometimes if the users have the streams, they can use these streams. If not, the model will generate and model can use the streams. Similarly, user defined watersheds. Okay, model will also generate the based on the digital elevation model sub watersheds, and then use, or if you have the predefined watershed boundaries, you can use it. Similarly, in case of the outlets. So this is the complete procedure of the SWAT model. These are the inputs required for the SWAT, and then these are the three different you can say processes. Okay, watershed delineation is the one step, then HRU definition and the weather stations, or we need to provide the weather parameters. Okay, so after creation of the database, these are the important three steps which we need to provide for the SWAT model. Okay, then we run the SWAT model, and then if there is any again we observe the output with our observed output, and if it is mismatch or if it is not correct, then we check the, or we edit, or we edit the inputs, okay, for getting the correct simulated output. So I am not going into detail. These are the data formats which we require in case of the QGIS or QSWAT, like DM, which we need in terms of the grid format. Similarly, land use land cover maps. Then each of these, like say land use land cover map, in addition with the land use land cover, we need to also create the lookup table for the land use land cover map as well as the soil map. Okay, so the lookup table I will show you during the demonstration. This is basically important for linking the layers, okay, the special data sets. Okay, then the streams and user defined watersheds outlets we have to provide, then tables and text data files. Okay, so that way I will show you during the demonstration. Then the plant, if the anyone is working on the related with the crop related things, or the nitrogen or the fertilizer or pesticide related work, then they have to be careful about the crop related parameters. Okay. Then these are the in case of the land use. Okay, so this is very important. I will show you during the demonstration this one, all this. Then preparation of the weather database. So basically in SWAT, we need to have the weather parameter we have to provide. Okay, so based on the weather parameter, there will be the different statistics will be calculated. Okay, so this basically I will show you based on the weather generator, how we can estimate the different statistics which we required for the creating the SWAT database file. So these are the important things which we need to specify in case of the SWAT input database file. That also I will show you during the demonstration. Then we have to check the data for missing values. Okay, and then we have to correct it. We have to fill this missing values. Otherwise, SWAT will automatically will simulate and it will fill the missing values. Okay, then point discharge data, like we have the observed data sets, we have to see the observed stream data set, stream discharge or stream flow, or the different loading data related with the sediment or the point source. Then the potential evapotranspiration, I think I have already explained you. Okay, so now before installing the SWAT, QSWAT, we also need some of the basic softwares, okay, like Microsoft Windows, Microsoft Access, then WinZip, Microsoft Dot Framework, and Acrobat Reader. These are all are the basic things which we required for the SWAT model. So here, how to first of all now how to install the QSWAT. Okay, so first of all, we need to install the QGIS software. So you can download the QGIS software by using this website. Okay, install the QGIS. Okay, there are many versions are there. It depends on your computer's compatibility, as well as what are the, which one you need to use the software. So you can install the QGIS software. Then second, you have to download the SWAT editor. Okay, this is the second software which we required for the SWAT installation. So this is available on the SWAT website. This one, you can download the software, extract it, and then you can install the software just by doing the double click. Okay, so SWAT editor, there is a 2012 SWAT editor is available with the SWAT. Then next one is the QSWAT. Okay, so once you install the QGIS and Q editor, then you can install the QSWAT. So you can download any latest QSWAT version software from the SWAT website, and then you can install the QSWAT. Okay, so once you install the software, then you can go to the plugin of the QGIS, and then under the manage and install plugin, you can find the QSWAT. So I will show you during the demonstration this one. So these are the also some of the SWAT user groups. Okay, you can find very useful for you for interaction and this one. So SWAT basically considers the different parameters, like, okay, which are related with the surface runoff, then waste flow, groundwater, then snowfall, temperature, then there are so many related with the soils, okay, groundwater, then related with the crops. So these are the parameters basically important for the model calibrations. Okay, so to identify how model is sensitive for any particular parameters. Okay, then once you identify these parameters, then you can correctly calibrate and validate the model. So now this is all about the creation of the database. Okay, now I will just show you one case study, and then we will go start the demonstration. So this is the one of the case study which we did it for the micro watershed, very small agricultural watershed. Okay, from the Maharashtra state. Okay, and this is the complete procedure for like if you want to study the how the potential of the runoff, surface runoff, as well as the groundwater recharge in the watershed. Okay, so what are the things important we require? We need the special data sets like digital elevation model, land use, land cover maps, soil maps, and slopes. Okay, which slopes which we can be it can be derived from the digital elevation model. And from digital elevation model, we need the stream network. Then we need to specify the area threshold and watershed delineation. Then reclassification of the land use, soil, and slope. Then HRE threshold we have to provide, and overlay analysis. Then the SWAT model can be set up. Okay, then non-spatial data, we need the meteorological data, hydrological data. Okay, and then we need to provide through the SWAT. Okay, so then next one is the SWAT cup calibration. So I already told you there are two methods which we can use. One is the manual calibration, and another one is the auto calibration. Okay, so if you are satisfied with the model results, then you go further, or otherwise you again check your inputs and revise your input database. Okay, so this is the brief methodology which applied for the this case study. Okay, so these are the digital elevation model, this is the land use land cover map, and this is the soil type map. Okay, and these are the again reclassified into the SWAT formats. Okay, so these are basically, there are two watersheds we have applied, and these are the parameters we considered for the model calibration. And this is basically, I'm not going to show you SWAT cup because we don't have that much time, but this is we have how we can identify the sensitive parameters. Okay, so it is very easy. From the SWATCOP, we can easily identify the sensitive parameters, and we can just provide those sensitive parameters for the model. And then we can simulate the, we can calibrate and we can validate the model. So this is just to show you how the model can be calibrated and validated. Okay, so this is with the observed and simulated output. If your observed and simulated output matches with your simulated output, then it can be said that the model is following the our model can be calibrated, model is calibrated good. Okay, so then further you can study the water balance components of the watersheds. Okay, like precipitation, how much is the precipitation occurred in the watershed, then surface runoff, lateral flow, return flow, then deep aquifer recharge, then shallow aquifer, this revamp, then potential evapotranspiration, then total aquifer recharge, how much is this recharge occurred. Okay, so then you can also specify how much is the runoff occurred in the watershed. Okay, and then you can compare with this. So this is a brief case study. Okay, I'm not going in detail. As I already told you, it is very difficult to show you within a 1 hour. Okay, so am I audible now? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Okay, so now I will show you the practical demonstration of the SWAT, soil and water assessment tool, okay, which is through the QGIS software. Okay, so basically I'm going to demonstrate you the QSWAT now. Okay, so I'm just sharing the screen again, or my screen is visible, Dr. Vikram?
Yes, sir, your screen is visible.
Okay. So basically, we need to have the softwares. First of all, I have already explained.
Sir, sir, the presentation screen we can see, but the, I think.
Okay. I have to stop the presentation. Okay.
Yeah, you can.
Then I will share the screen.
Yeah.
My folder is visible.
Yes. Now it's visible.
Okay. So basically, what we required, different softwares. Okay. So these are the softwares. Like first of all, we need the QGIS software. Okay. This is the QGIS software. I have already downloaded from the website, and also the link is also mentioned in the website. Okay. So you can download the software. Then in addition with the, once you double click and install, then you have to install the SWAT editor. Okay, this is the 2012 SWAT editor. This is the zip file. You can extract, okay, extract. And you can just simply double click on the setup file. This is visible, Vikramji?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay. Then next one is the, you need to install the QSWAT. Okay. So there are different versions are there. Okay. So you have to say, you have to install the compatible version for the QGIS. Okay. So suppose I have installed in my computer the QGIS 2.61. Okay. So you can install, you see which one you can install the higher version of the QSWAT. So basically, I have installed the SWAT editor 2012 and the QSWAT 1.7 version. Okay. So similarly, you can just extract the QSWAT. Okay. And this is the file. And you just double click and it will be installed. So now I have already installed, because otherwise it will take more time for the installation. So I'm not going to show you a detailed installation. Okay. So these are the important softwares we require. There is one more software we require, that is SWAT weather database. Okay, so suppose I just want to show you. This is the SWAT database file. Okay, so this SWAT database, it is basically designed for the US conditions. Okay, so all the parameters you will find for it for the US conditions. So suppose if you want to apply the SWAT for the other parts of the India, other parts of the US, like for India, then this soil database, which will not work out. Okay. So as similarly, the in case of the this weather generator, this weather files, okay, this all statistics by default model will provide, but it is very important the participants has to change this one. Okay, so for your watershed you have to create this database. Okay, and how you can create this database, this is very simple. Okay, so you can simply you can use this software that is called as the SWAT weather database tool, SWAT weather database. So you just extract this one, okay, and you can see there are documentation file is given, that is the manual is given. You can use the manual, similar as well as sample example data set is also given. Okay, this one, like say how the data can be provided. So these are the input file basically, like say this is the rainfall, this is the date, okay, stations and the precipitation. Okay, so you remember,
instead of sharing the folder, can you please share your screen? So there is an option in the
it is not visible.
Your Excel sheet is not visible, so can you please share the entire screen? So there is an option share screen, so that whatever you are doing on the screen we can see.
I think I have to stop this sharing, then
it will now this time please share the screen, entire screen.
Okay
so it will not again
Now it is okay.
Yes okay. Fine.
Just remember, all the participants in the SWAT, in the computer laptop, okay, if you see this one, this is the date format. Okay, in India we generally use the day, month and year, but SWAT does not recognize this data format. Okay, so whenever you install the SWAT, before installation you just change your data format in the laptop or the computer. Okay, first should be the month, then date and then year, otherwise your model will not run properly. Okay, it will give the error. So this is the for the precipitation or the rainfall. Similarly, there is a other database files. Okay, and there is a one important file, stations. Okay, so these are the like number of stations in the watersheds. Two stations are considered, then its station ID, or you can give the name, then longitude and latitude, then elevation. Okay, you have to provide the elevation. So this information you have to provide, then you can use the this weather database. This is the main, you can say, Microsoft Access file. Okay, you can use it for the creation of the this characteristics. Okay, this is one, this one. So there is a less time, I'm not going to show you detail how to create this weather database. You can simply follow this tutorial. Okay, it is very easy, very simple and easy. Okay, so this is the I think it is visible properly, so you can simply use this file, okay, from here. Okay, so you can use it and you can create the statistics, like manage the stations. Okay, and you can provide all these inputs. Okay, whatever the inputs we have, you can provide the inputs and then you can create this file. Okay, so once you run that program, finally you will get this, like this file. For two stations you will get the, all this database. Okay, so I'll just close this one and this is the WGen user. Okay, so I already shown to you, so you can just, so I'll just close this one. Okay. And now next important thing is, once you have the QGIS in your software, so I am now showing. So now see, once you install the QGIS software, there will be a shortcut. Okay, this, like this. Okay, QGIS 2.61. okay, so you can just Okay, there is some error, but there is no problem with this. There may be some programs are still needed, but still it will work, no problem. That is, it will not affect the QSWAT. So just to demonstrate you, so like say, once you install the QGIS, then SWAT editor, and then ArcSWAT, QSWAT, okay. So then you just go to the plugin, then manage and install plugin, okay. Then you just search the QSWAT, okay, QSWAT. Okay, if it is not installed, then you have to install it. Like say here, there will be the option, okay. Uninstall plugin or reinstall plugin. So because I have already installed the plugin, that's why, and then it is showing. Okay, so it will be shown here on the QGIS software. Okay, so you can just click on the QSWAT. Okay, this is the main QSWAT software. Okay, main interface of the QSWAT. Now what I will do, I will take one of the example just to learn you or to demonstrate you the QSWAT software. I'm not going very complicated. You can say the example. I'm just taking the QGIS demonstration example data sets. Okay, so this is the example data sets. Okay, so this is just, I have run the test file, test project. I'm just deleting this one. So this is the example data sets. Okay, so in the example data sets, which is available on the QGIS also, you can provide the climate. So these are all the input database, okay, for the weather variables. Like this is the for the precipitation station information, okay, the longitude, latitude, and elevation. Then if you want to see the corresponding precipitation statistics daily, okay. So I already informed you that the SWAT works on a daily basis inputs. Okay, so this is the input you have to provide. If you see, this is the daily data of the rainfall it is provided. Similarly for other variables, okay. So this is the complete climatic variable. Then next one is the digital elevation model. Okay, you can select either 30 meter digital elevation model or 90 meter digital elevation model or any specific high resolution digital elevation model, which should be in the grid format. Okay, so this is the digital elevation model. Then the next one is the land use. Okay, so land use is also should be in the grid format. Okay, then the main outlet file. Suppose if you know or if you have a location details of your outlet of your watershed, then you can just create a shape file, point shape file, and then you can provide this as a one of the important input for the model. So basically it will help us in delineating the watersheds and the sub watersheds. Then the observed data sets. Suppose now you have the outlet, and then you should also have the observed flow recorded at the outlet, okay, which will be useful for the model calibration and the validation. Okay, so you can just create this one in Excel file, okay, like date and the flow in meter cube per second. Okay, then the next one is the if you have streams, okay, if you have the stream network already existing with you, correct one, then you can also provide that stream network when you when you delineate the watersheds. Okay, so that the model will SWAT will adjust accordingly you with your existing stream network. Okay, then the next one is the soil map. Okay, so soil map should be in the grid format. Okay, so there are different formats are there, maybe most of the participants they knows. Okay, so this is the, and then the other inputs we require, that is the land use, land cover, lookup table. So we have the land use, land cover, but SWAT recognizes only these codes. Okay, so the land use, land cover is linked with these codes. Okay, let us say for water, agricultural land, pastoral land, forest. So whenever you specify or you create a special map of land use, land cover, you have to provide these are the SWAT codes in case of the each of these land use, land cover classifications. Okay, and similarly for the soils. Okay, so these are the codes for the soils. Then the next one is the, there are two files. Okay, one is the user soil. These are the, as I told you, okay, so these are the characteristics of each of these soils available in the watersheds. Okay, so like the how many layers are there, then high soil hydrologic group, then depth of the soil, then texture, okay, then bulk density, available water holding capacity, clay content, silt content, sandy soil. Okay, so all these statistics is available. We have to provide whatever the soils you have in your watersheds. Then this is the same. Okay, this is just created for, I'm just deleting this one. So by default in the SWAT, you will find this user soil. Okay, so as I have already shown you in the model earlier, just before some time. Then the next one is the weather generator. So for your watershed, you have to provide this input information, okay, which is created from the weather database, that tool. Okay, so I will just this is complete database for what are the database we required for the SWAT model. So now we will start demonstrating the SWAT model. Okay, so by default I just deleted that file. Okay, so now what we will do, I will just demonstrate the QSWAT from starting from the input database to the model simulation. Okay, and then after this we will have the question and answer. So it will, this will take at least 15 minutes or 20 minutes, just bear with me. Okay, so first thing is you have to click on the new project. Okay, so if you want to create the new project, you have to create the new project, and if you have the existing project, you can just click on existing project, it will open. Okay, so click on new project. So I'll be, and then just see the folder, proper folder where you are creating this one. Okay, so I'm just creating test project. Okay, test project. Test project. Okay, just save it. So now all your work, it will be saved in that folder. Okay, then the first step, if you see this SWAT QSWAT interface, there are main steps, three main steps are there, which I have already explained you. The first one is the watershed delineation, then the next one is the creation of the hydrological response units based on the different sub-basins. Okay, then third one is the edit input and run the SWAT model. Okay, and there is a few SWAT parameters. So first of all, we have to go by step. So first we will delineate the watersheds. Okay, is this screen is visible? Vikramji?
Yes sir, it is visible.
Okay, so now select the digital elevation model, first input. Okay, so now just go to the folder, like I have the data sets, example data sets in the data folder. So I'm just selecting the digital elevation model. Okay, so in selecting this digital elevation model, you just select the HDR.ADF. Okay, this file. So this is the now the digital elevation model is imported. Then the next one is the delineation of the watershed. So as I have told you, there are options is available burn in existing stream network. Suppose if you think that if you have a correct stream network, you can import that stream network, okay, and you can use it, burn it in the current project. Okay, so it will adjust the stream network accordingly. Or so then there is also other options are also there. Like if you have the watershed shape file, stream shape files, inlet outlet, you can use it. Then you can see this DM properties. Okay, so now for the time being, then the next step is we are not, because I don't have the stream network, so I'm just skipping this one. And then next one is the define the threshold. This is very important. Okay, so threshold means what? Like how much details you want to visualize a particular watersheds. Okay, so if you give a very less threshold, it will generate a more subbasins. Okay, or more stream, not more streams. Okay, very small streams also it will visible. But it depends on you how much levels of stream network you want to see. So now in this case, by default, it came 0.8. So I need, like, let us say 0.7. Okay. You can also change the unit. Okay. Like square kilometer, hectare, square meter. Okay. So generally, we take a square kilometer. Okay. Then you just click on the create streams. Okay. Then you see, this is the digital elevation model open, and these streams are created now. Okay. These are the streams created. Okay. Now, suppose if you want to do the watershed delineation, with this, it will generate the complete, it will delineate. But if you know the watershed outlet which you are interested, then it will be helpful to you. So now in this case, now we have with us the watershed outlet. So I will just import the watershed outlet. This is the main outlet. Okay. So you can just click on the main outlet.dbf file and it will be imported. Okay. So now this is the outlet, it's added here. Now there is an option in case of the QGIS, this that is snap threshold. That means suppose if your outlet is little far from your main stream locations, then the model will automatically it will capture. Okay, it will snap. In my case, my model it is around 700 meters away from the main outlet. Okay, so I just given this one, and now I will just create the streams. Okay, create the watersheds. So I will just have to click on the create watersheds. So it will generate the watersheds. So this has considered this as a main outlet and delineated the complete watershed. Okay, so these are the sub watersheds. Now you have to just click on, like, sometimes, most of the time what happens, like, there are, if you see this one, there are different sub basins are there, but if you want to merge, you can also merge the sub basins together. Okay, let us, for example, I will just select the sub basins for merging. Okay, like, say this, you can just click on the sub basin which you want to merge. Okay, so I will just click, press control, and then select the next basin which one you want to merge. So these two basins I want to merge it. Okay, so just save it and click on the merge. If you see, now these two basins are merged together. Okay, so this is very useful. Then suppose in your watersheds, like if you have some reservoirs or pond related ponds are there, or any artificial water harvesting structures are there, you can add those shape files here. Okay, but remember, you have to also have the all the storage dimensions of that particular structures. How much is the inflow, how much is the outflow, then only it will be considered that the contribution of these structures into the water, into the model calibration and validation, and finally simulating the water balance component. Okay, so now I don't have the related information about these structures, that's why I will just skip this one and I will just say okay. Okay, so now it is just creating a complete report. If you see now, my watersheds are 10 sub watersheds are there, and my outlet is located on the 10th number sub basin. Okay, so this is the first step, completed watershed delineation. How we can delineate the watersheds by using the QGIS. Now, the second step, that is create the hydrological response units. Okay, now we have to provide this information. Okay, the first one is the select the land use land cover map. Okay, so just click on the this, then go to the land use land cover folder and select the hdr.adf file. Okay, so just select this one. Okay, then land use table, like I have already explained you about the lookup tables. Okay, so just select use CSV file, because we have the data related with the lookup table, it is in the CSV file. Then the next one is the select soil map. Okay, so just select the soil map. This is the soil map, and select the hdr.adf file. Okay, so this is the soil related information we have provided, and just select again the use CSV file. Okay, so then this soil data is user soil data. Now there is an option, generate full HRUs shape file. Okay, so just click on, if you want a very detailed information about the HRUs at sub-basin level, then you click, because otherwise, if you don't want, then you just skip that one. Otherwise, it will model will take more time for running the model. Okay, so just click on generate the full HRUs. Okay, so I need my time is, I think 15 minutes are there. So I think I will finish within the 15 minutes. Then we will have another extra 15 minutes for question and answer. So you have to click on this one. Then the next one is the set bands for the slope. Okay, so in your watersheds, you may have a different types of slopes. Okay, so I will classify the watersheds into the number of categories, like maybe 0 to 5%. Okay, so this is one category. Then let's say 10%, 5 to 10%, and then remaining is the greater than 10% will be included in the last class. Okay, so this is the information related with the slope we have to provide. Then click on the read. Okay, so there will be now the information is asked about the provide the land use lookup table. Okay, so now we have the land use lookup table here, like this is the CSV file. Okay, just import that one. Then the next one is the soil. Okay, just import. Okay, the soil. Okay, then so now then the next one is the click on the read. Oh, sorry, there is some issue. Yes, before Just I forgot to mention you. I have already mentioned you. Before creating the HRUs, you have to just 1 minute. You have to specify your this one. So just let us go to the your test project file. Okay, before starting the creation of the HRUs, just go to the project, test project. This is the test project. And this is the file, SWAT database file. Okay, this is very important. Actually, this step I have forgot. So what you have to do in this, you have to provide our watershed characteristics. Okay, if you see this one, just don't confuse with this one. Only we should deal with the two important files. That is, one is the user soil. That is the user soil, this one. Okay. So for the time being, I just rename this one and just say the old. Okay. Because we don't need this information. We have the our watershed information. Okay. Then just go to the external data sets and import the, create the new source. Okay. From then go to the from file and then import. Okay. So just browse the file where it is located. Okay, so it is located in this folder, this data. Okay, this is the user soil. Okay, I'm going to provide, this is the user soil. Just click okay, then say next, next, next. And here just say, choose my own primary key, that is the object ID. Okay, then the user soil, keep as it is. So this is the user soil came now for your watershed. Okay. So if you open this one, this is only for your watershed. Then the next one is the weather generator. This is, okay. So this is the weather generator file. You can simply go to the external data and new file. From file, you can just import it. There are many options are there. You can add in that also. Okay, this is the WGEN Robit file. So I'll just extract. Okay, choose my own primary key and this one. So it is came here. Okay, WGEN Robit. So this is the important step before going to the creation of the HRUs. Okay, now you just close it. Now you just create. Click on create HRUs. Okay. There now you have the land use map. Okay. I will just provide it again. No problem. It will take CSV file. Okay. This is also CSV file. Then just click on read. Okay. Now you have to provide the lookup table. Okay. Land use. Then for the soil, okay, some error is coming. Okay, maybe I have, we have to start the fresh project. Let us see. Actually, in case of the QSWAT, this is the problem. Like if you did something wrong, then you have to start from the beginning. That is the always better, so that there will not be any bugs available in the program. Otherwise, it is very simple. Okay, just it will not take much time. I will, if the time permits, I will do it again. Vikramji.
Okay, so no issue.
Yeah, okay. I'll just start from the beginning. Because I did that mistakes. That's why it is not running the program. Okay, so just again, the participant will also refresh. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So this is the, again, for the benefit of the participants, again, I'm just doing it, I just click on the grass, but we don't need grass. Yeah, this is the QGIS. Actually, I just installed in the night only. in this laptop. So maybe there is some problem with this version. That's why some error is coming. But I tried it. Software is working. So just click on the QSWAT. Okay. Then the new project. Then just provide the data. Okay. Oh, sorry. Just save the project. Okay. Just say now test one. Okay. So now your project is ready. Okay. Then just click on the delineate watershed. Provide the digital elevation model. Okay. This is the digital elevation model. Okay, then you can just, let us say, just 0.7. And we have the create stream. You can just create the streams. So these streams are created. Okay, then you can just provide the outlet. Okay, just select the outlet. This is the main outlet. Then you can just take this one and create the watershed. Okay, so this watershed is created now. Let us see. This is the watershed created. Okay, now the next step is you have to merge the sub-basin. It depends on you. If you want to merge, otherwise you can just skip it. But for just, I'll just show you again how to merge. Just click on the any sub-basin which you want to merge. Then the next sub-basin, just press control and just select and then save. Okay, then just click on merge. Okay, you cannot merge a sub-basin which has an outlet, inlet, reservoir, or not merging sub-basin with polygon value 10. Okay, anyway. So you can just see this one. Then the next one is click OK. Okay, because we don't have the other information. So these are the 10 sub-basins are created now. Okay. So now next is the creation of the HRS. So now you remember, we have to first of all, we have to create, update the SWAT database file. So this is the SWAT database. Just say enable content. Then the user file. Okay. So just rename this one. Old. And just open new file. Then browse. So this is the information related with the soil, user soil. Just say okay. Next. Then say let us choose my primary key ID. Then finish. So this is now the user soil is added. Okay. So you can either delete or otherwise you can keep as it is. Then the next one is the WGen. So WGen, you can just, again, you can import. So this is now for the WGen. So let us say this one, everything is there now, okay? Now I'll just close this file, okay? And now we will start with the creation of the HRLs, okay? So just take the land use map, okay? Land use. Then create a CSV file. Then again, take the soil map. This is the soil information. Okay, then click on use CSV file. Okay. Now you can define the slope classes like 5%, then 10%. Okay. Then let us say there is also other information, but first of all, just this read this one. Read a lookup CSV file. Okay, for land use land cover. So just for land use land cover, this is the file. Okay, lookup table. Then for soil, this one. Okay, so now see, this is working perfectly. So now here there are different options of HRUs. Okay, in the HRU creation, whether you want to consider the dominant land use land cover or soil or slope classes, or whether you can just consider the dominant HRUs, or you can filter also. Filter by land use, soil, and slope. Generally, we use the filter options, okay, based on the knowledge available on the watershed, or otherwise by filter by area or target number of HRUs, okay, how much HRUs you want. So now let us say we will go by the filter approach, like say 10% weightage we will give for land use land cover, then for soil we will give the 10%, and then for the slope we'll give 5% weightage. Okay, so it depends on the watershed characteristics. Okay, we can specify like this weight. Then create, click on the create HRUs. Okay, if you see, now it will create the HRUs. Okay, so the HRUs are created now. If you want to see, now there is a the parameters are highlighted. Select report to view. Okay, you can view the HRUs here. Okay, you see here there are number of HRUs. Now you see, now 46 HRUs are there. Number of basins are 10. And then you can see all the detailed information HRU wise. Okay, so I'm not going in detail, already we are running late. You can also edit input and run the SWAT. Now this is the last step of our model running. Okay, so now if you see this one, there is a one folder created. Okay, that is test the scenario. Okay, this is very important default. And you can find the text in test out. That means now this is, we have not run that one, that's why it is not came. So we will now edit inputs and run. So when we will click this one, before doing this one, now we have to connect the SWAT database with the SWAT editor. Okay, so in this case, what you have to do, if you see this one, the SWAT parameter geo database, you just copy this file, okay, and provide our new SWAT database file to this one. Okay, so just click on. So this is also important thing you have to remember. Okay, you have to provide, you have to connect the folder, okay, to the SWAT database. You just say connect to the database. Now you see database connection is successful. Okay, now next thing is you have to provide the weather related information. Okay, so weather stations, this is the weather stations we have now, WeatherGen Robit. Okay, and for that we have the rainfall data. Okay, see, suppose if you don't have the data, model will simulate for itself. Okay, but always it is better you have to provide the observed data sets. So now I will just provide the data. Okay, so this is the example data, climate, and here there are, now these are the detailed precipitation data, but we have to give the PCP drop station, the station information, okay, where everything is stored and this file is linked. Okay, so just click on okay, then give the temperature data. So I'm running now little fast so that we'll complete within time. Then the next one is the temperature. So if you see the temperature, this is the file. Then for the relative humidity, okay, relative humidity, it is here. And suppose if you don't have any data, you can just skip that one. Like say, suppose if you don't have the solar radiation, you can just skip that one. A model will simulate itself. Then there's the wind speed. You can try this one, wind speed. Okay, then it say okay. So all the files are now imported into the database. Okay. There is no issue with this. There is some issue. So now the processing is complete. Okay. Then just close this one. Then the next step is write SWAT input tables. Okay. So now this is the file. So just click on the configuration file and select all. Okay. Then click on create tables. So basically, it is saying use weather database to calculate the heat units to maturity. So this is applicable only in case of the US condition. So just say no. Okay. Then it is asking, do you want to rewrite the existing files information? Just say yes. Okay. Just say yes. Yes. So all the files are written now into the SWAT database. Okay. Now this process is completed. And you just close this one. Okay. Now, then the next step is database update. Suppose if you want to update any parameter related with the subbasin or the HRU, you can update it from here. Okay. Like this. Then next is the edit SWAT input. Sorry, from here you can edit the input. Like say, suppose if you want to input the any information related with the soil. Okay. So here you can just click and you can input, okay? Like say bulk density, if you have the observed value, these are all default values. So you can just edit this one, okay? Then the next one is the run, okay? This is the run SWAT model, SWAT simulation. Now our everything is ready. Now we have provided the data from 1990 to 2030, okay? Then click now. Next is the rainfall distribution. Then we are following the daily time step. Okay. Then SWAT version, on which version you have, we are running the SWAT model, like 32 bit or 64 bit. Okay. So here there are two options, 64 bit debug and 64 bit release. If you use the debug option, you will get all detail analysis if there is any problem. Okay. Or running details. If you use select 64 bit release, then model will not show all this other information. Okay. Then the next one is the printout setting. Okay. Then there is a daily, yearly, monthly. Okay. Then there is one more option, that is NY skip. That is, this option is generally used for the warming. Okay. That means initially the model will try some simulations. Okay. To warm up the model. Okay. So generally we do give some simulation warm up period, that is like say 1 year or 2 year, so that model will auto calibrate, okay, for some conditions. Okay, then now in this condition we will select the monthly. Okay, then it depends on your what outputs you want. Just you just select it and then just select the SWAT setup, SWAT run. Okay, so now model is set up, SWAT model, and then next is the you have to create the run the SWAT model. So now you see SWAT is running. So it depends on how you have given the inputs and how many runs you want and whether you want daily time step or the monthly time steps. Okay. So now within a time, a model will run. So it will not take much time because we have I have taken a small watershed, so it will just finish. Vikramji, we are running little late, no problem?
No sir, no issue.
Okay, now
within 5 minutes we will
within 5 minutes
demonstration, and then obviously we will take 10 to 15 minutes for the
because now almost finish. Okay, yes. Now SWAT is run successfully. Okay, so now you can just close this one. Now we don't need this file. Even you can see this one now, the main SWAT editor. You read SWAT output. Okay, so you can import the required files which you want, like related with the reach, subbasin, HRUs. Okay, you can just import it. So now SWAT database is imported. Now I just want to show you what I earlier I was showing you. So here, okay, what happened here? It's not coming. Okay, model is run properly, but only the my computer is slow. That's my problem. Anyway, so you can see this one, all this text in and text out. That means this is the input parameter, this is the output parameter. But in this folder, you will find all the important files related with this one. Okay. So now, suppose if you want to see the how much is the output came at the main outlet. Okay. That is basically the flow. Okay. So you can see this is the flow. This is the sediment yield. This is the organic matter. There are so many things are there. Okay. But you can see this flow. Okay. So this is looking 0, 0, 0. Okay. Why it is looking 0, 0? Because we have given a 2-year warm-up period. Okay. So for that 2-year model will run for the simulating for the idle condition. Okay. And then model will simulate for the after 2 years model will, this is basically called as the warm-up period. Okay. Model will get set and then model will run. So this is now model. You can see the, there is a flow is there at the outlet after the 2 years. Okay. So this is the one important file which is required basically with the for the SWAT model. So this is the simulated model. Now simulated outflow at the main outlet. Okay. So like this, you can also find there is one more file HRU or sub basin. You can also find sub basin wise output. Okay, so this is the output dot sub basin. Okay, these are all notepad files. Okay, you can see all the water balance component of the watershed. It is visible here. That is potential evapotranspiration, then surface runoff, then groundwater recharge, shallow groundwater recharge. So everything you can find it here. Okay, this all this. I think okay, this is okay. Now, if you have the observed flow, okay. So let us say this one is the, I have the data observed flow. So this is the observed flow. Let us say this is the observed flow. So you can just compare with the simulated flow. So this is the observed flow. Okay. So 2 years we have given the warm up period. So you can just compare with this one and then see how the model is performing. Okay. So whether the model needs the further modification or not, or whether the model capturing the peaks properly or not, you can just see that one. I think my computer is hang. Model is run successfully. Meanwhile, we can take some questions, Vikramji. The option you can visualize the outputs. Okay, so now you can see. Let us say reach. So reach generally we observe the flow. Okay, so we have the data from 1992 to 2013. Okay, then you can select the flow, like say now outflow. Okay, then just add it. Okay, then select it again. Then let's say monthly means. Okay, so you can just see here, it will visualize here. Create. Okay, you see like this, it will show you how the flow is varying. Again, you can print it, you can do whatever you want. You can also see the animations. Okay, you can say the variable, like say flow, how the flow is varying over a period of time. If you just click on play, it will show you. If you see, it will show you. See, you see, similarly you can see how sub-basin wise flow is what are these hydrological components of the water cycle is varying. Okay, so you can also plot. Okay, what I have shown to you. I think this much is enough for the beginning, for the familiarity of the SWAT model.